Welcome to a video on the trigonometric form of complex numbers. The goals for this video are to graph complex numbers, convert a complex number in rectangular form to trig form, and then convert a complex number in trig form to rectangular form. Since a complex number in the form a plus bi has two components, the real component and the imaginary component, we can graph a complex number similar to how we graph vectors, except we use the complex plane instead of the coordinate plane. So the x-axis becomes the real axis, so we'll label this with A, and the y-axis becomes the imaginary axis, so we'll label this with B. So now if we want to graph the complex number 2 plus 3i, A is equal to 2, B is equal to 3, so we plot the point 2, 3, and this can be considered the terminal point of the vector starting at 0, 0, and going to the point 2, 3. There's the graph of 2 plus 3i. If we want to graph the complex number 4i, you might want to think of this as 0 plus 4i. So A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 4. 0, 4 would be here. So we have the vector from 0, 0 to 0, 4. To graph negative 3, we could think of this as negative 3 plus 0i. So that would be the point negative 3, 0. See here, so there's our vector. And then lastly, we have negative 1 minus 4i, so A is negative 1, B is negative 4, so we have the point negative 1, negative 4, and the vector starting at the origin, going to that point. Let's talk about complex numbers in trig form now. The complex number a plus bi and angle theta can be given by z equals r times the quantity cosine theta plus I sine theta, and this is considered trig form of a complex number. So here's a graph that compares a complex number graphed in rectangular form versus trig form. If this is the point a, b, where this is the real component, this is the imaginary component, we could also identify that point using r and theta, where r would be the magnitude of this vector, and theta would be the angle this vector forms with the real axis. And this sketch looks very similar to what we were doing when we were converting a rectangular coordinate to polar coordinate, except now instead of using x and y, we're using a and b. So these equations should look very familiar. R represents the magnitude of z, sometimes called the modulus. Theta is sometimes referred to as the argument. And sometimes we use this short notation to represent r cosine theta plus I sine theta. Let's go ahead and try a few of these conversions. We want to graph the complex number and then convert to rectangular form. So this is pretty straightforward. Our angle theta is pi over 6 radians, and the magnitude is equal to 12. So this has length 12. This would be the graph of our complex number in polar form. To convert to rectangular form, we just have to evaluate cosine pi over 6 and I sine pi over 6, and then multiply by 12. Pi over 6 is 30 degrees, so let's sketch a 30 degree reference triangle. So we'll have 12 times cosine of pi over 6 would be square root 3 over 2, plus I times sine pi over 6, that's 1/2. Now we'll distribute. So we'll have 6 square root 3 plus 6i. We can check this on the calculator. Now we can just type in what was given. It will give us the decimal approximation for 6 square root 3. We can go ahead and check that as well. And looks like everything looks good there. Let's try another one. This is written in the abbreviated form. I'm going to go ahead and rewrite this. So 3 times cosine 150 degrees plus I sine 150 degrees. So theta would be 90 plus 60 more degrees, somewhere here, reference angle of 3 degrees, we'll need that later, where this has magnitude of 3. So at the end of that vector, we have a point which represents that complex number. Let's go ahead and put this in rectangular form. So let's go ahead and put this in rectangular form now. We need to find the cosine and the sine of 150 degrees. So we'd have a 30-degree reference triangle. Since we're in the second quadrant, the square root of 3 would be negative. So we're going to have 3 times the cosine of 150 would be negative square root 3 over 2. The sine of 150 would be 1/2. Let's go ahead and distribute. So we have negative 3 square root 3 over 2 plus 3/2 I. Let's go ahead and check this as well. To change our mode back to degrees, we can see the imaginary component is correct. Let's go ahead and convert this to decimal form to verify. That looks good as well. Let's go ahead and try to convert a complex number into trig form given rectangular form now. Let's go ahead and sketch this. So A would be negative 2, B would be positive 2. Let's start by finding R. R equals the square root of negative 2 squared plus positive 2 squared. So this would be 4 plus 4, or square root of 8, which is equal to 2 square root 2. Next, we should be able to find theta, since we know tangent theta is equal to B over A. B is 2, A is negative 2. We want to know where tangent theta is equal to negative 1. Now if we use our calculator, try to find inverse tangent negative 1, it's going to tell us it's negative 45 degrees. The problem with that is that's actually in the fourth quadrant down here. We're in the second quadrant. But we can tell it's going to be a 45 degree reference angle from that. So our angle is actually going to be 135 degrees. And that's all we need. Z equals 2 square root 2 times the cosine of 135 degrees plus I sine 135 degrees. And there we go. Let's take a look at one more. Let's go ahead and sketch it in rectangular form. We have the point 3, 5 on the complex coordinate plane. Let's go ahead and find R. This would be 9 plus 25, that's 34. 2 times 17, so this does not simplify. Now we need to find theta. Tangent theta is equal to B over A, or 5/3. Let's go ahead and go to our calculator. Problem here, it does not come out to a nice angle. So a lot of times what we'll do instead of estimating this angle, we'll go ahead and just write this as theta would equal inverse tangent 5/3. So we'll use this as our angle. So in trig form, we would have z equals square root 34 times cosine inverse tangent 5/3 plus I sine inverse tangent of 5/3. So again, if the angle doesn't come out to a nice angle, a lot of times we'll leave it in inverse function notation. I hope you found this video helpful.